Hello there. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on what part of the world you're in. I am, of course, Chris or Az, and I've got a new microphone, which means you can actually hear what I'm saying, which is amazing. Today, and over the next maybe week or so, I'm going to make a series of tutorial videos. I know in a lot of my videos I've lost a lot, but that's beside the point. We don't take note of that. But a lot of my friends play this game, and they don't know what they're doing with the game. They don't understand. They make mistakes. They play things in the wrong order. They make a wrong deck. Things that aren't explained in the basic tutorial. Like, the tutorial for this game is one of the best I've ever seen. Bar none. It's fun, it explains the basic rules, it gives you an idea of what you're doing, it explains how the different mechanics work. It's fantastic. However, I don't think they've updated the tutorial with each new expansion, so it doesn't go into things like Inspire, I don't think. I don't know, I've not started the game to, but I don't think it goes into Inspire, I don't think it goes into Death Rattle, I don't think it goes into Synergies. It just basically explains how to attack, how to buff things, very, very basic. So what I want to do is make a series of short tutorial videos, because I know a lot of my friends don't have the time to sit there and watch a 45 minute video, explaining how to do different things. And I'll start in an order that hopefully makes sense. So, with that in mind, today we're going to do crafting a deck, and we're going to explain how crafting a deck works. Like, anybody can throw random cards together, but if you want to get the better cards, you need to win, essentially, and to win you need a decent basic deck. Now, I've already made a basic deck. I've made a priest deck, and it is literally, I'm going to rename it Basic Priest. Now, why I've called it a Basic Priest is because it is only using cards from the basic set, which are spellbound cards. These are cards that anybody can have. The only thing is that you need to level your priest up to at least level 10 to get all of the priest basic cards. All the other cards you get as you go through the tutorial and the innkeeper battles. There's a fair amount of them. I think there's something stupid like 60 or something, so it's a fair choice. And if you make a decent enough deck, then you'll still win. You might not get past, say, rank 17 or 18, but by that point you can have at least done your daily challenges, which will get you gold, and you can at least win a few times, enough times to get more free gold, which you can then use to buy packs. So what makes a basic good deck? For a priest, has a few vital concepts. Health, stealing the other player's cards, and just basically controlling and fucking with your opponent. You want, in a basic deck, some heavy hitters, which they have in the basic. You know, War Golem, it's a 7 cost for 7. So you get 7-7-7, that's a good stat line. It's a solid minion, and it's good for endgame. Mind Control is the most powerful card in the game, bar none. It's a game changer. And that's a spellbound card. Everybody can get this card. And what it allows you to do is take control of a minion. Any minion. It's your entire turn, but it is control of a minion. So if somebody puts down a legendary taunt, Paladin, for example, I can't remember the name of it, but it's a 6-6 with a death rattle that gives you a 5 attack weapon with 3 durability. You can take control of that, which means they then can't hit your health, and if they do take out the taunt, you get a weapon out of it. Incredibly powerful. Stormwind Champion. another fantastic late game minion. Give all your other minions 1/1. And it's a 6/6 for 7. So it's got less stats than the War Golem, but that's because of its ability. And that's the thing. That's how they balance it out. They make the better minions with better abilities cost more. Holy Nova is your AoE or area of effect. Which deals 2 damage to all your opponents and restores 2 health to all of yours. Sengen Sealmaster, again, just a basic minion, 4 cost, 3/5 good stat line, and it's a taunt. Like I said, you want some decent taunts in your deck because it stops them hitting your health. And that's what you want. You want to slow them down until you can get the board control and hit them in the face. Chillwind Yeti, one of the best cards in the game because it's just a really good stat line. They have since improved on it a little bit with the mech expansion, the Goblins and Gnomes, with the basically the Mechanoid Yeti, which is exactly the same, 4 mana, 4/5, but it gives each player a spare part, which is a new mechanic that they added in the Goblins and Gnomes expansion. But for a basic card, you can't go wrong with it, because there are cards that you can buff with it, there are cards that you can add taunt to, so there's a lot that you can do with it, and it doesn't go away very easy. There's only a few cards in the game that actually deal 5 damage, other than weapons. One of those is the Hunter, the Kill Command, but you need a beast on that, so that's a combo, so it means that it becomes a not great cherry if you're having to do that in one turn, because it uses all your turn up. Your Shad Sun Cleric, 3/2, not the best stat line, but it gives another friendly minion 1/1, so that then makes that a 5/6. Just a basic taunt. Iron Fur Grizzly, 3/3 for 3, not the best stat line, but a very good early defense. Very rare that you'll get cards that are good removal that do more than 2 damage early game. So it's good for shutting down. Shadow Word Death and Shadow Word Pain, 2 of the best priest cards, though they have a major weakness, and that weakness is 4 attack minions. Shadow Word Pain will destroy any minion with 3 or less attack, so it's good early game removal, and Shadow Word Death will remove any minion that you choose with 5 or more attacks, a good late game. But if you get 4 attack minions, priests are gonna struggle. They have ways around it, but they will struggle. Mind Blast, not the best card in the game, but I play quite aggressive decks, and in my priest, which isn't just spellbound, I have the Archmage Phalmos. No, it's not. Ignore that. Prophet Valine. Archmage Phalmos is a mage card, what am I saying? Prophet Valine, which doubles all spell and healing. That then becomes 10 damage. Spell power priest works really well, but I'll explain about themes and gimmicks in another video. Divine Spirit, double any minion's health. There is another card that I haven't been able to have put in this deck because I tried to stay true to it, which is Inner Fire. It is a common, so it only costs like 40 dust to craft, and that equals the attack to your minion's health. So a very good and still practiced priest trick today is make your minion's health as high as possible, and then using Inner Fire, and you can one-shot your opponent. I've done that to many of my friends, to much of their dismay. Northshire Cleric, incredibly good card, especially if you can keep it alive. Every time you heal a minion, draw a card, and that can be your minion or the opponent's. Powered Shield, draw a card and give 2 health. Again, going with that. And Mind Vision, steal your opponent's, steal 1 card from your opponent's hand. There is another stealing card, but again, that's common, and that is Thought Steal, and that steals 2 cards from your opponent's deck. Again, very good for fucking. So yeah, that's generally, it's just about choosing good solid minions that go well with your hero. If you're a mage, you'd want a few spell power in there, you'd want I mean Archmage. Spell power, spell damage plus one, and it's a 4/7, which makes it incredibly hard to get rid of. Also for a mage, what works well because it goes with your hero power is your Kurabashi Berserker. Every time it takes damage, you gain 3 attack, and it works well with both warrior and mage because they both have ways of pinging essentially for very little damage that still triggers the effect. So yeah, it's just about choosing what minions and what spells work really well. There's a few that I could have added but didn't because I didn't really see the point. Raid Leader's a good card, it gives all your other minions plus one, but it dies really easily. And also the Hunter has a spell card, which is incredibly good. Because I know a lot of my friends play Hunters, which is I can't remember the name of it. And I will remind you. Animal Companion, which summons one of three beasts, one of which is a 2/4 that does exactly the same as the Raid Leader does. But it's an RNG thing. Right, I've babbled on for long enough. I'm going to take it in and see how we go. Hope that I win with it. Because otherwise, what I've just said to you looks like a complete waste of time. However, I am ranked 17, and this is when you start to get the more competent players. That's my excuse, and I'm down on sticking to it. Once I've played a match, I'll end the video, and I'll do another one on a different theme. So we'll go into gimmicks and symmetry. So again, it will be making a deck, and it will be using cards that aren't basic, but it will show you how synergy and you can make gimmicks and themes and other such things. And I will probably do that with the deck because begin.
The light
I like
shall
the
bring
best,
victory.
And Beast Synergy is really good. I really should put my phone on so I don't want to make these videos. So yeah, we're going to keep all of this because Hunters don't have a lot of early removal. In fact, they have a lot of removal but not a lot of AoE. So
is someone injured?
North Shark is pretty safe to live. He could have an arcane shot because a lot of people go base hunter, but they, I don't know. It depends where he plays. No, oh, you don't actually see that kind of play card. Using common and basic cards. I mean, the Shadow of the Tiger is actually a really, really good card to have. Johnny's Empress, I want to keep that alive so that I can Mind Vision and double its health next turn. Which will allow me to keep it alive longer and draw more cards. And then in the turn after that, we'll play the Chill and Gurt and see what we can do with it. The other option is to just Mind Vision, see what you've got in his hand. And then play the Chill with Yeti and Divine Spirit. I think that's what we're going to go.
Right away.
I think we're still going to go with Chill Wind. We are definitely going to go with Chill Wind. So this is a we'll go with Taunt.
Tazdingo!
Forget just how many good minions I've actually got. Web Spinner, good card. I'm not a fan of the Ball of Spiders that they've brought out, which is 6 mana. You get 3 Web Spinners, but it's not brilliant, in my personal opinion. Yeah, we're gonna put this up.
Job's done.
Perfect. that's a 3/10. It's not brilliant attack wise, but he doesn't know I don't have an inner fire, which is the only really annoying thing about this deck. What was that? That worked. That way it'll either take 4 damage to kill it, or it'll kill it with the Stranglethorn, and then whatever minion I get, I can use to kill it off. That could be a thing. And if he just detects me, then I can do it to Shadow Wind.
Put this apple on your head!
That works quite well. Amazing. I'm actually very happy with that. I will play the Stormwind Champion next, so long as he doesn't kill the 3-2. If he kills the Fairy Dragon, then I will knock down the Chillwind Yeti behind him. I may just do that. Yeah, we'll do that anyway. That's fine. It's gonna be a
job's done.
Which will be another video that I will make on the creative stage and how not to do that. Once you know the traps, you should be able to play around them. And I didn't. My minions, then it would have been hard for him to get rid of the Chillwind Yeti and everything else. So that was my fault. That was my error. But I hope this has given you some tips, and the theory is sound. You can make a competitive deck with just basic cards. I just suck. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time, hopefully.